Hello, Easy HJ, how are you, man? Well, I'll just get everything set up and then we'll be good to go. Hello, Heathrow Aviation, how are you, my friend? That's good to hear, mate. Yeah, I'm not too bad. I've got work in the morning, so come back down to Heathrow. I've been working from home for the last 2 days because of the horrible conditions around where I live. Hello Michael, how are you? Thanks for joining in on the stream. That's good to hear. We're going to be doing a lot of manual flying today. Thought we'd do a bit of Caribbean flying because it's a bit snowy over here in the UK, so I thought why not head over to the Caribbean and fly around there for a little while. So we're currently flying over to St. Barth's for that hill landing. From St. Martin. Yeah, I agree, the weather would be a lot nicer over there at the moment. Plain spot from the beach. Hobbit Airlines working to the stream. No, it's not P3D, this is FSX. It's literally just playing FSX in 2017 with a lot of add-ons, which probably enhance it to make it look great. I haven't made the transition over to P3D yet. Not too keen on it. Yeah, Michael, it was sat at minus 5 for most of the day here. It was pretty rubbish, to be honest. I'm also really hoping I don't mess up this landing, because we have to land down the side of the hill, so that'll be interesting. Have we got any passengers on board today? So there is autopilot on this aircraft. You can tune it in down by the radio on the right hand side, but you'll predominantly use it manually flying for short haul trips. Our destination is literally that island over there, so we've got to try and land down the side of a hill. You might have seen it on TV on it's world's scariest airports or something like that, but yeah, it's pretty tough to land here. Thanks, man. Hopefully it wasn't too bad. I've landed a few times, but hopefully it'll be a successful landing. Full flaps. And try and reduce the speed and touchdown as quickly as you can, otherwise you'll go into the sea, pretty much. Don't know whether you can see that smoke over there. My little chimney is where we need to be and line up with. literally coming in on full flaps and trying to slow this down as much as I can. Visual on the runway now. This will be interesting. Here we go. That was rough. At least we stopped in time. It just kept picking up speed as I was coming into land, and then started floating because of the full flips. And wave hello to everyone that's sat on the beach now, and that guy just jogging up. I don't know if you can see him just there. We are going to fly over to Sabah as well, which is the shortest runway in the world that is in commercial use. And you literally have to land on the side of a cliff, so that'll be funny. Yeah, I thought I was going to end up in the sea, but luckily the brakes seem to be doing quite well on this. Plus, it probably doesn't help that we're full of fuel. I don't think we'll need full flats to take off though. Should be good with about 3 notches. Look at that descent, literally, comes straight over the top of the hill. Brilliant. You can even see the little dude riding his bike. Some guy in a little smart car. Alright, let's make our way over to Saba. If I can remember whereabouts it is. Pretty sure I can. That was quite a quick takeoff, to be fair. That picked up speed quite nicely. And yeah, it definitely isn't any Heathrow. You wait till you see the next airport we're going to. Hey Jake, how you doing, mate? Long time no speak. Thanks for tuning in. Man, good luck with them exams. I'm sure you'll be fine. Study hard for them. Right, that island over there on the just about north of Saba. That's gonna be, it's the world's smallest runway over there, so it should be fun to try and land that side of a cliff. Quite a crazy landing. Yeah, it wasn't the best. It could have probably been better, but it's the first time I landed there in probably about 4 months. So, not too bad. Twin Otter is actually quite fun to fly. I never used to enjoy it, but it's not actually that bad. I don't mind prop planes, I obviously prefer my civilian jets and jet liners and stuff like that. But it's nice to be able to go like on a VFR flight and just kind of fly visually propeller planes. There is the airport, it is absolutely tiny. It is smaller than the last one. This is the smallest commercial runway in the world. So it'll be interesting. actually managed to land an AC-130 here, which is interesting. Just lining up. I line up with this rock that you might be able to see in the sea coming on our approach. Literally probably about 2 minutes to touchdown or less. Yeah man, Twin Otter it is. Just coming into land in Saba, the world's smallest runway. So it'll be quite interesting. Also thanks for tuning in. Thank you very much, it'll be interesting. Just landed at St. Bart's and then flew from St. Bart's over here to Saba, so we'll see how it goes. If not, it'll be a touch and go and a go around. You literally have to get these things perfect when it comes to landing at Saba, it's crazy. Otherwise you're off the edge of the cliff. I think we're coming in way too high. Way too high, I think. Yeah, actually we're just gonna float now. It's the only issue. Don't know whether to go for a go around. No, we're doing a go around, that is way too high. I'm kind of literally coming to land on the opposite end by this time. I know it was too hard, I just started floating. Attempt number two, here we go. No, I'm coming in way too high again, I'm gonna go around for the other one. I'm gonna come in on full flaps. I actually managed to land a C-130 Hercules at Sawa flight sim. I've got a video on my channel, it's quite interesting. If you have a look at my channel later on or something, you should be able to see it. Literally got it pitch perfect. Took quite a few attempts. Yeah, we flew to St. Bart's earlier, that's where we just flew over from. That was quite, we managed to land the first time, it was a bit rough, but it was interesting, to say the least. Right, this is looking slightly better. Battered by this wind though, it's really frustrating. It's like a little crosswind, but it's just such a tiny aircraft, it affects it massively. Well, that was a close one. It just floated just as I was at my, just didn't touch down. I had my trigger on the brake, finger on the brake, but Jesus. Right, we'll get it this time. We got a lot closer that time. Hello Mr. Hoonigan, welcome to the stream. I do actually play X-Plane 11 as well. I do have it on a Mac as well. I've done a video on that before, on the performance wise, but we just recently got a new one, so I'll get it started on running the new iMac and test out how it is on that. Right, it's happening this time, I swear. There we go, attempt 3. No, attempt 4 maybe. Slow down in time. Wouldn't slow down in time. Came away too quick. Oh yeah, I need to use the flaps a bit more. I thought I was getting way too much lift. This is really interesting. I hope it's funny to watch. It's certainly funny to try and over and over and over again to try and get this right. Yeah, that was a close one. A very, very close one. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Finally. I use a keyboard, not a keyboard, sorry, I use a joystick, lovable. Right, finally, we got it successfully right on the 5th time. Where should we fly back to now? Princess Juliana or St. Barth? Where do you guys think? St. Barth, from Sabre, where should we fly back to? Princess Juliana or to St. Barth? Right, we'll do the Juliana run then. Just nip into the toilet, it won't be a second. Right, I'm back, everyone. We are flying back over to Giuliana now, so enjoy the ride. We're going to cut across the grass because that's just how we run. Right, I'll just be right back. I just got to go and speak to someone quickly. I'll be about 2 minutes and we'll take off, head back over to Giuliana, so that'll be interesting. Make sure you stay put, go and grab yourself a cup of tea and get some food for the journey back. Hello everyone, I am back. I do apologise, I was just talking to someone important. But we are now back and we are off to Princess Juliana. So I hope you enjoy the journey. Make sure you get your nice cups of tea and your food in for it as well, because it's going to be a rough one. And then we're heading back over to St. Bart's again afterwards, so that'll be even funner. The 172 is very nice to fly. Have you ever tried flying the Twin Otter? It's not the it's a great aircraft to fly, it's pretty difficult to land sometimes. St. Bart's is just over there, just on the right engine side, just over there, and then we have Princess Juliana, which is just in front of us. Hello Heathrow, nice to see you back again. I will be down at Heathrow Airport again for work tomorrow, so that'll be fun. There every day of the week usually, except for the last 2 days where I've been working from home due to the adverse weather conditions. Guys, would you like to hear a funny story? And at the moment I'm on my placement year from university, so I work within Heathrow, well, for Heathrow Airport directly. So at the moment I kind of manage quite a few different projects. I'm kind of working on Heathrow, Britain's busiest airport at the moment, and basically working on some applications that can be used within the business. So it's pretty cool. It's like project management. I'm going to learn how to do it all at the same time to get on the phone. What sort of videos would you like to see from when I'm at work? Because obviously I spend a lot of time around the airport. What sort of stuff would you like to see? Yeah, talk about the TV show. At the moment I'm involved with helping sort some stuff out around the baggage sort of area. Pretty cool really, it's nice to get involved with. kind of really want to fly on the Grenadines. I need to get the Animus in one. I don't know how much it is. Also, I've got a new, new video coming out soon, which is about the best AI tracker cat on FSX, which is cool. I was given it flight one, and you get to have a look into it, but it's pretty cool. It's like the newest AI tracker cat on out there at the moment, so it's pretty cool in what they add to it. Plus, it's frame rate friendly, which everyone loves. Yeah, I agree with you, man. I used to see that plane like day in, day out. It used to be a Heathrower pretty much all the time. It's been planned and everything. Don't know whether it's definitely going to go ahead. It's all like to do with politics and the government and stuff like that. So we'll have to find out, but we should find out within next year sometime. But if it does, it'll make a significant improvement to Heathrow. I wasn't monitoring the approach then, so it's lower altitude if it comes to it. Yeah, I completely agree. I think it's more likely to happen than not, though. I think there's too much that's gone into it to make it not happen at the present time. going to try and land on the first officer position. It'll be interesting. Here we go. I'm probably short arms now, really. Coming in quite speedy, but you know, it's not too bad when coming in semi. They have a lot of time to slow down, so it's very, very good runway for us. Make the most of it. That was quite a nice landing. I've never actually landed from the senior officer, senior first officer position. Word. That's unexpected. That was very unexpected. So the plane thinks it's a great idea to land while I'm landing. Yeah, nice one out with traffic live. Yeah, see, look, he's just gone off the runway now. Epoxy thing. Bloody simulator. That was interesting. Right, where should we fly to now? Should we fly back to St. Barts or go back to Saba? St. Martin's very busy right now. A lot of planes. I'm just about to take off. I'm joined by my girlfriend now as well, so if you have any funny questions you want to ask her.
Hi.
Well, we're off St. Barth now, so that'll be interesting. Again, hopefully we can do a better landing this time, Michael. Shall I get my girlfriend to try and land the plane? I just think it'll be interesting. I think it'll be fun. Let us know in the comments. In the chat, I think. Yeah, I think it'd be a lot. I don't know whether we should get to do it down the hill though or on the beach. If we go really, really hard, hard like landing way, or should we go from the opposite side when you just land from the beach? She doesn't think it's a good idea, and she just wants to, because she's scared she's going to crash. So I'll land, but I'm going to try and teach her how to do it at the same time. Has anyone got any questions you want to ask in the chat? Doesn't it have to be aviation related, it can just be general life or whatever. We don't actually have any of that in the house. She's not a massive drinker anyway. She prefers lemonade. And lots of lemonade. Obscene amounts of lemonade. And tea. Everyone likes a good old bit of tea. Hello Firestrike, how are you, mate? Just coming in on approach to St. Bart's. Being drawn by my girlfriend as well for the final approach in. Criticize my every move. My placement ends in September next year. So I've got a good old little while left, and Firestrike, no, I'm not on that sim. I still need to reactivate my account because I haven't flown on there for a little while, but I'll get it sorted, and we can do some group flights on there if you guys fancy. I'm going to try and come in with no flaps and see how we're doing. There's no flaps at all. Just literally, we're going to come in, a bit of speed, and see if we can slow down in time. Don't think it'll work, but we'll give it a go. Yeah, got a little while, and I'm currently studying business and management at the moment, but I hope to be a pilot one day, so it's kind of like a sort of thing just to keep me going in the meantime, degree I guess, kind of backup plan. Michael, my girlfriend would like to know what you do for a living. just on the topic of jumps. I am so off centre as I'm around. I better line up properly. But on that flap, so it's not staying very steady at all. I don't think this is going to work very well, guys. Interesting job, my mum's like that as well. And this is going to be rough, I can tell. Coming in at 100 knots, literally down the side of the thing. Hopefully, we can stop in time. Let's go. I don't know how it's going to go. How are we going? I think I'm going to crash too. Oh my god. That was absolutely solid. It's floating. There we go, we're running now. It's not going to slow down in time now, so I don't think. Slow. Please slow down. Otherwise, we're joining that gauge on the beach. No, I think we got it. That was lucky. Very, very lucky. Well, I think that was a pretty good landing considering we had no flaps and we came in at over 100 knots. Right, there's a plane on the runway, and I don't know whether it's getting closer or not. I think it possibly is. Or it's waiting for me to get off, either way, I don't know. We'll find out in a second. Yeah, I should have done a go around, it was a close one. At least we landed it successfully. I was trying to test out if we could land at St. Bart's with no flaps, and coming at about 100 knots. Which we did successfully. We floated a little bit, I flared too early. I thought the plane disappeared then, but then I realised it's over there. Beefcraft King 350 Roberts. Quite a big percent bar. I'm guessing you mean change with YouTube now, yeah. I changed it because I kind of wanted to do other things other than just flight sim. Like, I like cars and stuff like that, and like playing other games, so I thought if I kind of brand it as like my initials and then just TV at the end, it would probably make more sense than just having it dedicated to FSX. So it allows me to kind of do my car reviews, play other games like Call of Duty and FIFA, and just do like real life stuff with my girlfriend as well. So that was, yeah, it's a bit generic, but it kind of allows me to be able to. Amanda says, Janjot, Sora, hello. Welcome to the stream from my girlfriend and myself. But yeah, that's pretty much why I changed it. If that makes sense. Right, where should we fly to now? Should we fly back to Saba? I think we should fly to Saba and hopefully see if we can get it first time instead of on the 7th attempt. I think I got it on last time. Thanks for subscribing, it means a lot. On our way up to 700 subs, nearly at 200,000 YouTube views as well, and videos. So we're getting there, guys, we're getting there. And thanks, Michael. Yeah, I've got the actual car review for it coming out soon. So I've given the car back to Ford now, but I've got the actual review coming out soon. It's quite fun. It's fun to drive. Miss it slightly. It's a nice big car. But... yeah, my girlfriend's with me. She's not flying. I'm flying. But she's literally sat right next to me. Yeah, that is Amanda. She likes to get involved where she can. Just go and check out our YouTube channel if you want to see some of our daily life stuff. She vlogs sometimes, but she does makeup, I don't know. I'll be live streaming it. She'll go and watch me from another room on her laptop or her phone. Yeah, she's good, she's very supportive, and I try to support her in that sort of stuff as well, so it's nice. Help her edit her YouTube videos. And FSX default scenery, like, it's alright, like, it's nothing special, like, it definitely requires some add-ons to look good. But because of doing YouTube and stuff and the views that I've got, it's a lot of add-on companies seem to give me free, like, versions of their software, you know, to review and just use in my YouTube videos, which is nice. Geez, the visibility is dropped here. Yeah. The weather's changed from that to school. Well, I used to do it before this one.
Yeah.
And then we weren't really into planes in any way, shape, or form. And then I got you to go to Farnborough Air Show and sit down for 8 hours watching planes.
That was enjoyable, yes.
Well, no, I think you enjoyed the day, but.
It was good, it was just.
Yeah, the F-18 and the F-22 Raptor and the takeoff aren't either. Most, well, pleasant to listen to for myself, but for most other people it's probably not the funnest thing, because aviation fans probably really enjoy it, but I think most other people would have their own defenders on. I don't know where everyone goes to the right island or not. If you look into the clouds, I'm pretty sure that's Sarp over there. Fire Strike, Amanda says hi, she's just over on her view at the moment. Yeah, flights in world's meant to be good. I've never used it yet. It was, I saw the beta software of it, never got my hands, you now on the full version as of yet. Might try it out and see what it's like. I don't think it really updated it very well at the moment. And what do you mean by auto in X-Plane Fast Draw? And I try to stream as much as I can, but obviously I live down near London during the week. Come and stay with Amanda on weekends. So I can try to stream on weekends, if that's any help, or during the holidays when I'm actually back. Yeah, I got the Aerosoft AG training as well, it's really, really good. Top quality aircraft, that onto the rocks, and the twin otter that I'm flying at the moment from Aerosoft, so it's quite nice to fly as well. I think we're going to the wrong island. I'm pretty sure that is Saba over there. Yeah, that is not Saba, that's just a volcano, so I'm going right. Just making our way over to Saba from who went to the wrong island, especially when we're flying Vision. And it's a tough one because I had to work, I had to get quite a lot of views. I don't know how many views you've got on the YouTube channel. I've got about 200,000 views altogether now, so that kind of helps. From their perspective, it looks as if they can give me an add-on and I'll get them more people quiet if you get what I mean. So, by utilising like Flight One recently gave me their new Ultimate Traffic Live add-on to use. I'm still in the process of getting a review done for that, it's just time at the moment. But yeah, that'll kind of soon. That's pretty much how it's kind of building a brand reputation for myself, I guess. I've actually got the quality wings BAE 146, very very nice aircraft. However, it's not even installed at the moment, I've just got it sat here in the back of my computer somewhere with all the rest of my FSX add-ons. So yeah, I'll get it installed and might do some flights out of London City. Quite interesting. Oh yeah, that is definitely Saba. Well, we'll get there this time. Coming from the left hand side this time. I just filmed a new video actually today for what I personally think is probably the best FSX add-on you can possibly get. So I look forward to watching that. It'll be a good one as well. And I've got a couple of car videos on this way. One of my car with my friend, and one of the new Ford Edge, which Ford nicely lent me for a few days. I've got a new upcoming video with their Fiesta as well. 27, I think it's a 2018 Fiesta. They'll let me go in the next few weeks. So that'll be interesting as well. Right, Amanda's going now. She's going to go and watch TV with her mum.
Bye.
Go get to bed. Watch TV. See you in a minute. Bit of a dive here, and I know it's going to cause us to probably do a go around. However, I'm trying to reduce the speed while we can, so I'm just extending the flaps, and hopefully I can reduce enough altitude as well. Okay, hopefully Amanda will join me for some more streams. Could be more interesting ones. No, she's just tired, she's got work in the morning. Plus she wants to go and watch Coronation Street. What are you reckoning, guys? Go around or not? Or can we get this landed first time? Would you reckon? I think I'm a bit too high. Yeah, I'm one up too high, so we'll see how it goes. I need to literally land on the X if I'm going to land this straight away. But here we go. This will be interesting. A bit of a wind as well against us. Can I land on that X? Can I get down on that X? I'm getting a lot of them. Yeah, no, we're going for a go around. It wanted to land on the grass. Yeah, I think the twin otter is about £20 on there or something. It's not too bad. But yeah, student fees are really expensive. I'm currently studying business management at Aston, Birmingham. Yeah, it's like £9 like a year total. But just on my placement here, so it's not too bad. Yeah, Michael, that was really, really shaky. My apologies, I was probably concentrating on the chat here. Let's try it again, I'm sure we can do it this time. Going up again, way too fast. Welcome to the stream, War Gamer. It depends. X-Plane's good. so is FSX. Like, FSX is like the go-to choice probably for flight simulation. Like, X-Plane's like, I wouldn't say a newcomer to the market, but I definitely think their graphics are better on X-Plane. It's just, sometimes you have to have a really, really hard comp system to run it, because it's obviously very new, so it's running the latest tech. But I haven't updated my computer in 6 years, and it still performs like an absolute beast. So. I've actually got FS Passenger, strangely enough. Yeah, I should make my own. That's a really, really good series. We'll do it on the stream as well. Get you guys to join. I used to use FS Airlines as well, that was fun. Made my own airline on that. Me and Amanda just bought a brand new iMac, the top spec one, with like a quad core i7, 8GB graphics card, and 512 SSD. So hopefully, X-Plane 11 will run really, really well on that. So I might try and run it on that, because I've got the top spec 15-inch MacBook Pro, and it doesn't run that badly on that. And that's a laptop, so I can only hope for the best. Yeah, no, I agree. It's like FSX was made basically in 2007, so anything beefy around that time is probably not massively beefy now, so you could probably get away with like a GTX 1060, don't need a 1080. So you can have quite a fairly good machine that still allows you to be able to kind of play it happily. Coming in way too fast again, boys. Way too fast. Just gonna do like a bit of a circle. Good old Acer laptops. I remember the weirdest thing ever, probably some really strange story. We had this old Acer laptop, and my brother, when he was about 9 years old, thought it was a great idea to snap the screen off because it broke. And then proceeded to write "Rest in Peace" laptop in salsa sauce from a Doritos packet. Strange. Yeah, flaps are extended now. Give it a bit of a rudder and see how fast we can get the bad boys to turn around quickly. Oh my god, we just gained altitude pretty much. Let's do like an S approach in and be alive. Yeah, the Twin Otter is a nice aircraft. Depends how often you fly VFR though. I don't massively fly it a lot, so I'll just fly it as and when. Nice aircraft to have there. Yeah, the Doritos packet bit was quite funny. I still can't believe he did that to this day. He just literally, with his fingers, dipped it in salsa sauce and ripped, whatever you want to say. Rest in peace, laptop. He was like 9 years old at the time, so it's quite funny. That was a terrible laptop. Yeah, it is. I'm probably not concentrating as much as I should. I'm having quite a laugh and chatting with you all and looking at the chair. Rather than concentrating on my landing. Which probably isn't the best thing to do, but I guess it's quite entertaining for you guys to watch. Right, this is looking promising. It's got to be it this time. Got to be, surely. Cut the power, so here we go. Just glide in now. Use all the flaps. There we go, stop. 30 knots. We done it. I thought that was quite a good landing. Let's go up here and then turn around. Where should we fly back to? Should we go to St. Bart's or should we go back to Juliana again? Thanks guys, much appreciated. I should have been able to really do it first time if I was concentrating, but you know. Entertainment, I guess. Welcome back, Firestrike. I hope you're on. What a pretty little plane. Rolling forward by itself. Where do you guys think we should fly back to? St. Bart's, or should we fly back to Princess Juliana? Alright Michael, thanks for joining in the stream. Hope you can join in another one over the weekend. And we'll get maybe a long haul flight or something going. Yeah, I think Random probably will join with that one as well, so it'll be decent. Yeah, good night mate, and hope you enjoy work tomorrow. I've got work tomorrow as well, so I'm going to be up at 5:30, leave for 6, get there for like 7:30. Welcome to the stream, Gliding Central, hope you're well. And Firestrike, it's a tough one, because I made a few videos on my channel last year which done really, really well. Two of them both got around 80,000 views nearly, so that's kind of helped me out a lot. And that was reviewing add-ons and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm going to fly back to St. Bart's and see how this goes. quite a nice outside view, to be honest.
I love the chase plane that he's actually.
He's an add-on called chase plane, which allows me to get all these cool, nice views. And thanks, because I thought it was quite a nice take as well.
Yeah, I study at Aston in Birmingham, but I live in Milton Keynes, or on the outskirts of Milton Keynes, so it's not too far, about 50 minutes from the train.
Should I leave it in the outside view for coming into land, do you think, because I'm down the cockpit line again?
Could try it from a different view, up to you guys, see what you think.
Yeah, Wolverhampton's a big, big place. Lots of people.
It's not depressing just finding your rock. You don't want to be friends with people that, you know, just don't like to be in friends with you if you get on with.
I mean, that's quite a cool view as well. There's a volcano over there, I don't know if you can see it.
Cool, do many air pockets fly out there, or is it not really used here? So we live near our air piston, and we also live near Cranfield. So I work at Heathrow Airport as well, on my placement here, so I get to see a lot of the big ones every day. What do you guys think? Should I land it on the outside spot view, or should I land it in the cockpit? What do you guys think?
Yeah, definitely. I fly on that sometimes as well. I think I need to get my account reactivated. I haven't used it so seldom. Start our quite deep fast ascent to sandbars, probably pick up a bit of speed and we'll slow down with the flats. Yeah, it's really nice. Right, just coming in on my approach into St. Mark's, so hopefully it should be too bad. £3 landing, but at least we managed to get it out. I'm actually going to do that idea, man. I'm going to start up an airline with FS passengers and like stream when I fly for that airline and work my way up with all the followers. Quite cool, I think. Yeah, definitely. I'm gonna get that done this weekend. I'll get it all set up, up and running, and get cracking with it. Call it JTV Airline. Start off with a small plane, build our way up, start flying around maybe the Caribbean and stuff like that. What would you prefer to fly around, the UK or the Caribbean? Let me know. Also guys, I've got to be up at like 5:30 tomorrow morning. It's currently 10:30 in the UK, so I'm going to head off now. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. You should be able to backtrack and watch this video on my YouTube channel after it's sorted itself out and uploaded itself. I'll get the tags then sorted. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, well, stream. And hopefully I'll be streaming maybe Friday night. But if not, sometime over the weekend, we'll get the FS Passengers Airline set up. That'd be pretty cool, and we can start on that journey, and you can join me. Hopefully Amanda will join us on that as well. And a bit of fun while we're on the way, and hopefully keep you guys entertained. And you guys can chip in with ideas and whatever you want to do. So yeah. But yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you guys have a nice evening, and I'll catch you all soon.